Hey guys, welcome back to Honey Money SG. And in this channel, we are all about building financial knowledge, share money saving hacks, and also help you lead a fulfilling quality of life. So you will know by now that there are only two definite things in life, and that is death and taxes. And we should all do our part as local residents to contribute to our nation building, right? But before the year ends, let me just share about some of my tax relief strategies and maybe walk through them with you so that if you have not taken these strategies yet, you can consider taking them just right before the year ends so that next year your tax will be a bit lower. Anyway, professional tax advice is very expensive, so consider what I'm telling you is just for entertainment and for reference purposes only and not to be taken as real financial advice. Okay, first up, let's start with the simple ones, right? Let's talk about earned income relief. So earned income relief, everyone will have this if you're working in Singapore. Basically, you just get $1,000 off your tax accessible income, and this is automatically applied, so you don't have to go and write some application form or anything. So that's just government giving you some benefits. Okay, second one, also very simple. Let's talk about donation relief. So on IRAS website, right, donation actually gives you like 250% of tax relief. So what it means that for every $100 that you actually donate, $250 will actually be deducted from your tax accessible income. Now, even if you never choose to donate to any charitable organizations, most likely your employer has actually signed you up for some monthly donation according to your race, right? So for myself, I'm Chinese. So every month, I actually deduct like $1 or $1.50 into the CDAC. Okay, the Chinese something club. And that's to actually help some lower income Chinese families in Singapore to tide over their education expenses or household living expenses. So consider that as a goodwill. Of course, if you don't want to donate to anyone, then I probably think you can deregister yourself from the contribution monthly with your employer. Not sure how it goes, but I'm just keeping it. And for those who think that donation is actually a hack to actually reduce your taxes to a large extent, right? Then you may be really wrong. Because 250%, even though sounds like a large percentage, right? After all, you are still contributing to an expense because the tax relief is actually deducted from your tax accessible income and not like a full tax deduction of your tax expense. So if you're calculating like a net-net impact, it's definitely negative on your cash flow. But if you want to build good karma and just do some good for the society, then by all means. But do know that only those authorized charitable organizations under Donate SG or Gov are eligible for the tax relief. You don't anyhow go and donate to any dubious organization and then go to IRAS and say, I donated this amount of money and I want to get my donation tax relief. No, it doesn't work. Okay, next up is applicable for most of the males in Singapore who have undergone national service, and that is the NS Man tax relief. So for myself, I have attended my in-camp training, or some call it reservice, this year, right? So I'm eligible to $3,000 as a non-key appointment holder of tax relief. Non-key appointment holder means that you are below the rank of third sergeant. So if you are third sergeant rank and above, then you actually get like additional $2,000 of tax relief, which totals up to $5,000 of tax relief as an NS Man tax relief. But if you did not attend any in-camp training or reservist training this year, then it will be reduced by half. So for myself, it will be $1,500 if I didn't attend ICT. And then for the commander positions in key appointment holders, then they will be getting $3,500 of NS Man tax relief. Not only the NS Man itself, if you are the parent of an NS Man, then you also get $750. Likewise, if you are the spouse, meaning the wife, you also get $750 of tax relief. So really a lot of benefits if you marry a Singaporean male who is serving NS. Consider that. Okay, next up is one of the bigger tax relief items that I also talk a lot about in my channel, and that is SRS, Supplementary Retirement Scheme. So for Supplementary Retirement Scheme, I actually did like a whole video about it. Of course, SRS is a totally optional item to really reduce your taxes expense. So if you're not intending to invest your SRS money or you don't need that tax relief, there's really no point to do that SRS top up anyway. But if you want to find out what do I invest in SRS, then you can look at my Money Hour video and my Endowus video, because I actually deposit into them monthly and I always track my progress every 1 to 2 months to show you guys how my investments are doing, so that y'all can take a look before y'all go and invest the money in it. Okay, next item is actually CPF top-ups. Now for CPF top-ups, I will split it into two items. One is a voluntary contribution to MediSave account, VCMA. The other is the RSTU, Retirement Sum Top-Up to your special account. For voluntary contribution to MediSave account, I actually did like a full MediSave review video over here in this thumbnail, which you all can take a look. But basically, the idea is just to put money in your MediSave account. Of course, that is for the year of 2021, right? Because in year 2022, we have a brand new change of CPF amendments that I highlighted in my separate video for the year 2022, what's going to change. And that is actually the shared tax relief cap between your CPF top-ups. But what I did this year for 2021 is very simple. In the first of January 2021, I actually did a $3,000 VCMA to actually take advantage of the increase of the basic healthcare sum from $60,000 to $63,000. So that's $3,000 of tax relief there already. And then subsequently, I had a deduction for my CareShield Life premium as well as my Integrated Shield Plan premiums. So when the premiums are deducted, I also top up to my MediSave account because my MediSave account is no longer at the BHS when the premiums are deducted, right? So that's just some opportunity that you can actually take when they are outflows out of your CPF MediSave account. And it's also eligible for tax relief when you do such voluntary contributions. But moving on to 2022 is a little different. I already explained this in my previous CPF strategy video for year 22, right? So just take a look over here and what are my thoughts about year 2022 CPF strategies. Okay, the last one is actually retirement sum top up RSTU to my special account, which is $7,000, which I did in 31st of January 2021. I even did a video over here, right? So I teach you all how to top up and why should we top up the CPF-SA. Okay, but like I mentioned earlier for my VCMA, right? Similar, in year 2022, because the tax relief cap of $8,000 is actually shared between RSTU and VCMA, next year I may not be able to do the full $7,000 top up, right, for the tax relief. So take a look at my previous CPF strategy again for year 2022 on what will I be doing, because I will definitely not be able to top up $7,000 next year into my CPF-SA anymore. So if I add up all these tax reliefs for my year 2021 tax assessment, right, my total reliefs will come up to about $30,000 Singapore, which is not too bad, right? Imagine if you earn like $100,000 Singapore and then you deduct like $30,000 Singapore, so only $70,000 of that income is taxed. Of course, the only thing here is I don't earn $100,000 annual income lah. And of course, I've excluded my own CPF employee contributions, which are eligible for tax relief as well, right? Because otherwise you all will find out what's my income. Not that I don't want to tell you all, but my employment contract does not allow me to tell you all. So if not, I will get sued. But it's okay lah. Very simple, right, to calculate your own employee contributions, which is just 20% of your annual income subjected to the annual tax relief of CPF, right, which is like 72,000 of ordinary wages and 30,000 for the additional wages. Yeah, I'm sure you can do that yourself for the calculation. Okay, with that, so these are my tax relief for year 2021, and I hope that you learned something new. And if you have missed something out, then just take reference from my list and see if all these tax reliefs are applicable to you. Of course, there are other kinds of tax reliefs such as life insurance, causes, fees, but those are not applicable for me anyway, so I did not include them in this video. And don't forget to sign up for your Tiger or Moomoo Brokers account if you haven't, right, because you'll get one free Apple stock worth around $200 Singapore, and you know Apple is a really great company, right? So use my reference link to sign up to get that one free Apple stock. If you have found value from this video, do give a like at the bottom of the video. Just takes 1 second of your time and consider subscribing to my channel. Also join us over at our Honey Money Telegram group at Honey Money SG. If you want to learn more about tax relief, especially on SRS, right, then highly recommend you to watch this SRS video, which I did recently to actually help you out on your SRS, both of investing and tax reliefs. My name is Christopher. This is Honey Money SG, steering young adults to financial independence.